property investors love an emerging market story. So, how about Rwanda? The East African country is here at MIPIM for the first time showing property investors an ambitious new master plan to transform the capital city of Kigali. I'm here with the Prime Minister, Bernard Makuza. So, Mr. Makuza, why is Rwanda at MIPIM?
We are looking for investors for boosting our economic growth. We have a very good master plan which requires some investment.
What can you offer investors? Other African countries have oil reserves, mineral deposits. What does Rwanda have?
You can have oil or other thing, but without security, I think is nothing. We have a very good environment for investment. I think in Rwanda we have a very good legal framework, as even it is recognized by the World Bank doing business.
So you're making it easy for investors to come in, but are they worried about Rwanda's history and the genocide?
The genocide happened, yes, but it has been stopped by Rwandans. And since then, we are in a very different picture of Rwanda in terms of governance, in terms of economic growth, and even in terms of promoting the social well-being. There is a very clear vision from the leadership. We have everything in place, even when we compare with the our neighbors, even in sub-Saharan countries.
What kind of questions are investors asking you?
The picture people they have for Africa is very negative. Now, they ask questions relating to security, to some incentives, as I told you. And our response is very clear and very simple, because everything is in place in terms of governance, in terms of security, political stability, and I think we can find Rwanda now as the best destination for investment in the whole region.
At present, 70% of Rwanda's economy is reliant on foreign aid, and per capita income is very low, $1,000 per head. Could it be argued your plans are too ambitious?
We think really this plan is achievable. But sometimes the idea comes from some people. They don't understand how an African country can develop such a plan. But in Rwanda, we believe when we see, for example, where Rwanda from 1994 and where we are, this is not really so ambitious.
Are Rwandan people nervous of the Angola model, where China has come in, invested in real estate, built up a big city, only to take all the gains for itself?
The fear from one or another investor, I think that is not really a question which is, in my view, relevant, because the fault is not from the investor, but where is going to invest. So if you have a very clear and international standard, you don't have to have fear about one or another investor.
Infrastructure is a big challenge in Rwanda. In order to realize your vision, will you need to build new power stations?
Energy is a key factor to boost the economy. And we have a very clear program to produce 1,000 megawatts for energy within this 7 years.
Finally, tell me about broadband. I understand the government spent a lot of money ensuring Rwanda is connected to the internet, and that 100,000 school children have been given a free laptop.
Our children can be connected to all over the world by having this knowledge from ICT, from the laptop that they own now. Boosting the social well-being, but with a very direct impact on economic growth.
Mr. Prime Minister, thank you very much for talking to me.